part 2 of circles lesson. Right, question number 1. From a point Q, the length of tangent to a circle is 24 cm and the distance of Q from the center is 25 cm. Find the radius of the circle. One such question we have seen already in the previous class. Here you see O is the center of the circle and Q is a point outside the circle, external point. From Q up to P, a tangent is drawn, that is 24 cm length. OQ is of distance 25 cm. Between Q and O, distance is 25. And OP is the radius of the circle. From the first theorem, we understand that radius is perpendicular to the tangent through the point of contact. Point of contact is P, therefore OPQ is right angle here. So OPQ will become a right triangle. Therefore, we can very well use Pythagoras theorem, OP square plus PQ square equal to OQ square. We substitute the values. OP square we don't know. 24 plus 24 square equal to 25 square. OP square, that is 625 here, minus 24 square, 576, it is 49. So OP equal to square root 49, 7 is the answer here. Now, MCQs are not there, so they may ask you to find the radius of the circle. Okay, that way they may give the question, alter the question. Now question 2, here is about angles here. This problem, if you remember, we have a theoretical question coming up in the next in the exercise, that also will be easy for you. In this figure, TP and TQ are the radii, the tangents to the circle here with center O.
Why should I open this one? I don't know. Google account.
Right. So, we have to find angle POQ is given 110 degrees and PTQ we have to find. This angle we have to find. Now remember, POQT is a quadrilateral. Quadrilateral means it's a closed figure made up of line segments only, a polygon with four sides. It's a quadrilateral. So one of the angles is given, you have to find the opposite angle. But we already know angle OPT and angle OQT both are 90 degrees because they are radii and through the point of contact here, therefore they are perpendicular to the tangents. Therefore, OPT plus POQ plus OQT plus PTQ is equal to 360 degrees, sum of angles of the quadrilateral, angle sum property. So 90 plus 110 plus 90 plus PTQ, angle PTQ is equal to 360. Therefore, PTQ is equal to, sum of these is 290 subtracted from 360 is 70 degrees. So with this, we got this. And the simplest way, already we know that this is 90, this is 90, 180. So remaining angles, sum will be 180 degrees. If one of the angles is 110, other angle will be automatically 180 minus 110, 70 degrees. This is the shortcut. So opposite angles are supplementary in this case. Okay. Then, tangents PA and PB from a point P to a circle with center O are inclined to each other at 80 degrees, then angle POA is equal to, here I forgot to download the figure, I will show you how to do this. Here is the circle, say this is circle with center O, and PA and PB, say this is PA, A, and this is point P, PA is one of the tangents. Two tangents can be drawn from an external point, we know that, PB, this is PB. Of course, you think that it is B only, it is touching the circle. Okay, touching the circle. Now, and we have to find, this is the radii, these are the radii, OA and OB are radii, and we know they are inclined to each other at 80 degrees here. This angle is 80 degrees. We have to find angle POA. Oh, where is POA? PO, that means we join PO first. This angle is required here. If at all it is a total angle, we can easily find, but only half of that angle is required, or a part of the angle. Now, we shall first find the total angle here, that is 100 degrees. As I already told you in the previous case, in the previous problem, these two angles are 90 degrees each. Therefore, automatically sum of these two, AOB and APB will be 180 degrees. Here already it is 80 degrees. Therefore, AOB will be 100 degrees now. So, this angle will be 100 degrees. AOB is 100 degrees. We understood this. Next, let us compare triangle OPB, this triangle OPB and OPA. These two triangles we compare. 90 degrees. Okay, radius, and first we will not do about 90 degrees. This is also easy. Radii, tangents from external points and common side. Therefore, by SSS, these two triangles are congruent to each other. When they are congruent, these two angles are equal. Angle POB is equal to angle POA. And the sum of these angles we know 100 degrees. So each will be half of 100 degrees, 50 degrees. Therefore, OPB is 50 degrees. Easy, no? Now, question 4. Prove that the tangents drawn at the ends of diameter of a circle are parallel. Already we learned this in previous lesson, previous class. AB and CD be the tangents at P and Q. PQ is one of the diameters of the circle. Now, we can very well claim that OQC, since CD is a tangent, angle OQC, this angle is 90 degrees. Radius is perpendicular through the point of contact. Similarly, OPB is also 90 degrees. And these two, this is 90, this is 90. And these two are alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles are equal in when alternate interior angles are equal, we can claim that the lines forming the alternate interior angles are parallel. If alternate interior angles are equal, the lines forming those angles are they are parallel. That means AB is parallel to CD. That's all. So, tangents drawn through the endpoints of a diameter of a circle are parallel to each other. It is proved. Now, question 5. Prove that the perpendicular at the point of contact to the tangent to a circle passes through the center. For this, to prove this one, we use the method of contradiction. That means we say that it is not correct, and we try to build up the situations, and finally, once again, the opposite situation will arise. Therefore, we say that the given thing is right. The same is the case here. Let us assume that a perpendicular to AB at P does not pass through the center O, and let it pass through point Q. It is not passing through. You see, PQ is the perpendicular now. It is not OP, it is OQ. OQ is perpendicular, we are thinking. We know that AB is perpendicular to PQ. Now, AB is perpendicular to PQ. Then, it is 90 degrees angle, okay? Similarly, OP is the radius. We know that OP is the radius. But radius is perpendicular to the tangent through the point of contact. That means OPB is also 90 degrees. OPB is also 90 degrees as per the theorem. But our assumption is that QPB is 90. But by the theorem, we know that OPB is 90. That means these two are equal. QPB and OPB are equal. Two angles will be equal when the sides coincide. When their sides coincide, only then it will be correct. Is it not? So, it is possible only when P and Q are, sorry, O and Q coincide. That means the perpendicular to a tangent through the point of contact always passes through the center. That is proved. You understand? This is how we can prove the theorem, prove the statement given here. From question 6 and 6 onwards, all the questions are important. So concentrate and learn each one. Here we go. The length of a tangent from a point A at a distance 5 cm from the center of a circle is 4 cm. Find the radius of the circle. Very simple question, just like the previous one. Okay, here distance between the point and the center is 5 cm. And here radius we don't know. We don't know what is the radius. And we know the length of the chord is, length of the tangent is 4 cm. Again, same claim. Radius is perpendicular through the point of contact. Therefore, OBA will become a right triangle. We can very well apply Pythagoras theorem. So, by Pythagoras theorem, AB square plus OB square equal to OA square. AB square 4 square plus OB square is equal to 5 square. 16 plus OB square is equal to 25. And OB square equal to 25 minus 16, 9. OB equal to 3. Of course, you take the square root here and the positive square root. This is how we can find. So, in all these problems, Pythagoras theorem is also used. So, that you have to keep in mind. Next, question 7. This is an important one. There are two circles with the same center. Circles with the same center are called concentric circles. You know that. And the outer circle is of radius 5 cm. And the inner circle is of the radius 3 cm. Okay. Now, you have to find the length of the chord of the larger circle, which is a tangent, which touches the inner circle. Which touches means it is a tangent. Let us claim that PQ is the chord and it is a tangent to the smaller circle. Forget about the outer circle now. Only we talk about the tangent. Now, in triangle OAP, angle OAP is 90 degrees because tangent and the radius, they are perpendicular through the point of contact. Therefore, by Pythagoras theorem, PA square plus OA square equal to OP square, or OA square plus AP square equal to OP square, no problem anyway. 3 square plus AP square equal to 5 square, and 9 plus AP square equal to 25. AP square equal to 25 minus 9, 16. AP equal to 4. Now, AP value we obtained. Now, forget about the inner circle. Only outer circle you will take. For the outer circle, PQ is a chord and OA is a radius. And that too it is perpendicular. OA is a perpendicular from the center. Perpendicular from the center bisects the chord. This is what we learned in 9th class. So that means PQ will be two times of PA. Children, is anybody joining the class? PQ equal to 2 times AP. Therefore, PQ equal to 2 into 4, 8 centimeters. That is how we can find this question. Right? Now, I think you understood this one. Any doubt?
Yes, sir.
No. Okay.
No, sir.
Good. Now, we'll move on to the next one. Question 8. This is a very important one. It is because we have a quadrilateral ABCD is drawn to circumscribe a circle. Prove that AB plus CD is equal to AD plus BC. So, given that DA, DC and CB or BC and AB, they are the sides of the quadrilateral which also form tangents to the circle which is already inscribed within the quadrilateral ABCD. Inscribed means which is in the circle. Circumscribed means outside. Here we say quadrilateral ABCD is circumscribing the circle and circle is inscribed in the quadrilateral. Okay, now coming to the question here, we have to prove that AB plus CD is equal to AD plus BC. Observe carefully. We know that tangents from external point are equal. Let us start with D. DR equal to DS. Here D is the external point to this circle. So DR is equal to DS. We know this. Tangents are equal. Then C is also an external point. So therefore CR equal to CQ. Following. Next. From B, if you see, BP is equal to BQ. BP is equal to BQ. These two are also equal. And finally, A is also an external point. AP equal to AS. This one equal to this one. Now there are four statements. Up to here you understood, no? How to get these statements. Right?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Next.
Yes, sir.
We'll add all these four statements. What happens? DR plus CR plus BP plus AP is equal to DS plus CQ plus BQ plus AS. Right hand sides and left hand side separately I added. Then DR plus CR, BP plus AP I am taking into one cluster. And on the right hand side DS and AS I am taking to one cluster here. Why? Because DS and AS are a part of AD here. So they will make AD, therefore I take like that. Here DR and CR means that is CD. BP plus AP means AB and other two will form what is BC. So therefore CD plus AB, DR plus CR is CD plus AB here is equal to AD plus BC. That's how we proved it. Okay. You understood this one?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
That's fine. The same 11th question also is linked with this one. In the 11th question, we have to do all this and a little extension we have to give. Okay? When the case comes, I will explain that. So, hence we proved this one. The question 9. In this, xy and x dash y dash are two parallel tangents to the circle with center O. And another tangent is also drawn with the point of contact as C. It is touching the circles at A, it is intersecting the tangents xy at A, x dash y dash at B, like this. Now we have to prove that angle AOB is 90 degrees. This angle is 90 degrees. So, dekhne mein aisa toh lag raha hai, it is 90 degrees. I think it is 90 degrees only. We have to prove that. For proving this one, we will take the help of congruences. Once again, we take the triangles OPA, this triangle OPA, this triangle, and OCA, other triangle we take. In these triangles, we know that OP equal to OC because they are radii, and AP equal to AC because they are tangents from external point. Tangents from external point. OA is same as OA or AO. So by SSS congruence, these two triangles are congruent to each other. Then angle POA, this angle is equal to angle COA, this angle. So this and this are equal. Next. Similarly, you can compare these two triangles, triangle OQB and OCB. These two triangles can be compared. And we obtain a relation like this, QOB, this angle is equal to angle COB, this angle. Okay? So, these two angles are equal top of OC and at the bottom of OC, these two angles are equal. You may number them also if you want. 1, 2 are equal. and 3, 4 are equal. 3, 4 are equal. But 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, if you take, all that will become a straight angle 180 degrees, because that is the angle formed at O, and OP and OB, OQ are radii. That too, they are, it's on the straight line diameter, therefore it is 180 degrees. POA plus COA plus COB plus QOB is 180 degrees. And we write this, POA and COA are equal. So in place of POA, I will write COA. Then these two will become 2 times of COA. In place of QOB, I will write COB. Then these two will become 2 times COB. Then 2 is taken common, COA plus COB is equal to 180 degrees. And COA plus COB is equal to 90 degrees now, 180 by 2. Then what is COA plus COB? COA plus COB is together AOB. So angle AOB is 90 degrees. This is how we proved this. Simple, right? Simple question. Shall I move on to the next one?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Right. Question here. 10. Prove that the angle between the two tangents drawn from an external point to a circle is supplementary to the angle subtended by the line segment joining the points of contact to the center. Of course, this is already seen in one of the problems I already told you. See, POA is supplementary to AOB, we have to prove. APB, this angle is supplementary to the angle AOB. This is the angle subtended by joining the points of contact to the center. This is AOB. AOB and APB are supplementary. That means their sum is 180. This is what is to be proved. So, again, we give the proof. OAP is equal to 90 degrees. Why OAP 90 degrees? Because it is perpendicular. The radius is perpendicular to the tangent through the point of contact. So, that is 90 degrees. Here, this also is 90 degrees. Then, in quadrilateral APBO, sum of angles we take, APB plus AOB plus 90 plus 90 is equal to 360. Automatically, APB plus AOB plus 180 is 360. APB plus AOB is equal to 180 degrees now. So, we proved it very easily. Earlier, we did it. Now, we are proving it theoretically. We found the angle. If AOB is given, we are finding this angle. Okay? Next question. This question and the 8th question are linked actually. Whatever we learned in the 8th question, whatever is the answer for the 8th question, we have to write as the first part of this lesson, this question, as the answer, first part of the answer for this question. So again, we draw the parallelogram. Prove that parallelogram circumscribing a circle is a rhombus. So given DC, DA, BC, AB are the sides of parallelogram which also form tangents to the circle inscribed in parallelogram ABCD. We have to prove that ABCD is a parallelogram, is a rhombus. Okay, that means we have to prove that the consecutive sides or the adjacent sides of the parallelogram here are equal. How to prove that? Same. We proceed as in question number 8. And question number 8 is simply repeated here. DR is equal to DS, same. DR equal to DS, DR equal to DS. And CR equal to CQ, these two are equal, we proved. And then, because they are tangents from external point, BP is equal to BQ, and AP is equal to AS. Add these four, and we get this relation, DR plus CR, BP plus AP is equal to DS plus AS, we write on the other side. Then we'll have AB plus CD, or CD plus AB is equal to AD plus BC. Up to here, this is the 8th question. Now, A continuation to 8th question we will do. What is that? In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal, we know this. Therefore, CD and AB are equal. In place of AB, I am going to write CD now. And in place of BC, I will write AD. Those two parallel lines are equal. Those two sides are equal. Therefore, 2 times CD is equal to 2 times AD. 2 cancel. And CD equal to AD. CD is the side here. And AD is the side here. Edges and sides are equal in the parallelogram. That means it is a rhombus. Okay? So only these 3 steps are extra in 11th problem. Up to here, this is 8th problem. And 3 more steps if you write, that will become 11th problem answer. So these 2 you can learn together. And most often this question is asked. Right? This question was asked most often, so learn this one better. Now question number 12. It's a very important one because we have to do, it is the only lengthy question in this particular chapter. Okay? ABC is a triangle circumscribing a circle of 4 centimeters radius. Here, circle is of 4 centimeters radius, that is given. And here every radius is 4, and here we have a of course the each side is a tangent to the circle here, and D the point of contact for which BC is the tangent, D is the point of contact, and that is dividing this BC into 2 parts. One is 6 centimeters, another is 8 centimeters. We have to find the lengths of AC and AB. That is the question. So if CD is 6, automatically the other side also will be 6 because CD and CB, they are equal. CD and CG are equal. Similarly, BD and BF are equal. Okay, I named these points, of course, forgot to tell you. I am joining OA, OB, OC as well, drawing perpendiculars to the sides here AB and AC, which will become which will become the points of contact for the tangents here. Now these 2 are equal. We proved that, we know that. So sum of these 2 sides, 6 here, 8 here. If you know what is the length of AE or AF, any of these lengths, we will be able to find AB, length of AC and length of AB. So this is, let us say it is X, this is X. So all that we have to find is what is the value of X here. If you know what is X, AB will be X plus 8, AC will be X plus 6, that's all. So for this, we have to take the help of Heron's formula to find the area of the circle, area of the triangle, as well as area of the triangle by half BH formula we'll take. Then we divide this triangle into 3 parts here, triangle OAB, triangle OBC, triangle AOC. So these 3 triangles we form, and sum of these also will give you area, and by Heron's formula also we can find the area because we know the perimeter in terms of X, of course. So perimeter equal to X plus 8 plus 14 plus 6 plus X. X plus 8, X plus 8 plus this 6 and 8, 14, and X plus 6. Together it is 28 plus 2X, and 2 can be taken common, then 14 plus X here. This 14 plus X is a magic number in this particular question, remember that. So 2 cancel here, so S equal to 14 plus X. The perimeter of this, semi-perimeter of this triangle is 14 plus X. So, by Heron's formula, area of this triangle is S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. So, 14 plus X into 14 plus X minus 6 plus X. Here, this one. Okay, A. And then, 14 plus X minus 8 minus X. 8 plus X. This one. And third side, of course, we have, it's not printed here. So, that is 14 plus X minus 8 plus 6, 14 plus X minus 8 plus 6. 8 plus 6 is again 14. So I'll write 14 directly here, the third side. So here 14 plus x minus 6 minus x. So x and x are cancelled. 14 plus x minus 8 minus x. This x and x are cancelled. 14 plus x minus 14. So 14, 14 are cancelled. What is left out? 14 plus x into x here, this x. And here 8, 14 minus 6, 8. 14 minus 8, 6. So 8 into 6, 48. But 48 is equal to 16 into 3. Why 16 into 3? Because 16 is a perfect square. 16 into 3. For 16, square root is 4. So 4 is taken outside the square root symbol. 3 is left inside. And the remaining things we multiplied here. X into 14, 14x. X into 4, x into x, x square. Next, here we go. Area of OBC now. Now, one way we took the area here by Heron's formula. In the other way, we take the help of half BC formula. Half B is one of the sides and half BH. H is nothing but the radius here. So, that is 4 always here. This is 4. So, half into, for OBC, half into 4 into 14 here is the base. 14 into base. Half base 14 into 4. Okay. 2 times. So, 2 into 14, 28. The area of the bottom triangle we got. Area OCA. OCA means this one. OCA. The other side triangle. That is OF into FC. Again, 4 into 6 plus X. 2, 2 you cancel here. Then, here 2 into 6 plus X. 2, 6 is 12. 2X. Similarly, the other way, half into 4 into 8 plus x, again cancellation 2 here, and then here 2 into 8, 16 plus 2x. If you add all these three areas, you get the area of the big triangle. So that is 28 plus 12 plus 2x plus 16 plus 2x. And that will be equal to the area found through Heron's formula, because both are areas of the same triangle. No? Therefore, I am equating in this slide now. 4 into root of 3 into this one, etc. is equal to this. So 28 plus 12, 2x plus 16, actually not, this is not 16x, 16 plus 2x. Now, when you simplify further, this will be 40 plus 16, 56 plus 4x. And in this, take 4 as a common factor, then it will be 4 14s are 56 and plus 4 here, plus x here. So 14 plus x, again the magic number will come again. This 4 and this 4 can be cancelled on either side. So now squaring on both sides. When you square on both sides, the square root symbol will go away and we can be taken away on the LHS, and the RHS is squared here. So 3 into 14 plus x into x square is equal to this much. So again, 3 14s are 42x plus 3x square is equal to this side. I expanded 196 plus x square plus 28x. So this x square, if I bring this side, it will become 2x square, and 28x, if you bring this side, it will be 14x now. 42 minus 28, and 196 will come as minus 196, and all together we got a equation here. And this equation is a quadratic equation. Middle term is splitting, we'll split the middle term, of course divided by 2, then you get x square plus 7x minus 98 is equal to 0. Splitting the middle term, 7 can be taken as 14 in the 7, 14 minus 7, and 14 7s are 98, we know that. So taking the factors, x plus 14 and x minus 7, both are equal to 0. So x value can be minus 14 or 7. Here x is actually a part of a side. Length can never be negative. So we will avoid this one, and we take only 7 as the value here. Therefore, the side AB is equal to 7 plus x plus 8, that is 7 plus 8, 15. AC equal to x plus 6, that is 6 plus 7, that is 13 centimeters. This is how we get the answer here. Now, question 13 and the last one. Now I think you got this answer. Two times you have to practice this one, otherwise you will forget this. Okay, question 13 and the last one in this chapter as well as in this exercise. Here, prove that the opposite sides of a quadrilateral circumscribing a circle subtend supplementary angles at the center of a circle. Center of the circle here. So, ABCD is the quadrilateral circumscribing the circle. That means each of these sides of the quadrilateral are touching the circle, therefore they become the tangents here. So, now we name these, we will join the points of contact and the vertices to the center here like this. And by joining this way, we got the angles 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, we try comparing triangle OAP, this triangle, and this triangle OAS. On comparison, we can understand that AP equal to AS, they are the tangents from the external point, they are equal. OP equal to OS, they are radii. Then, OA is a common side, therefore by SSS these two triangles are congruent, therefore angle 1 equal to angle 8, CPCT. Similarly, we can claim that 2 equal to 3 and 4 equal to 5, 7 equal to 6. Of course the angles, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, angle 6 and angle 7. And the sum of all these angles will be 360 degrees because they are at the center of the circle. Together they form a complete angle at the center. Therefore, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 and etc. All these angles, sum of all these 8 angles equal to 360. And in place of 8, I can write 1. Okay. Like this. For example, in place of 2, I write 8. Sorry. 1 and 8 are taken together. 2 and 3 are taken together. 4 and 5, 6 and 7 are taken together because they are equal. So 2 times of 1, 2 times of 2, I will write for these two because 1 and 8 are equal. Therefore, I write here also 1, 2 times of 1. Here 2 and 3 are equal, 2 times of 2 I write here because this I will write as 2. And 4 and 5 are equal. Why I am writing like that? To form a relation between AOB and COD. These are the angles subtended by sides AB and CD. Their sum is 180. That is what I have to prove. Therefore, 2 times of 1, 2 times of 2, 2 times of 5, 2 times of 6 equal to 360. That 2 is taken common. And 2 times of 1 plus 2, 2 times of angle 5 plus angle 6 equal to 360. 2 is taken away here. So, this 2 also can be taken away. Right. So, angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 5 plus angle 6 equal to 180, right? Angle 1 plus 2 is nothing but AOB. Angle 6 plus 5 or 5 plus 6 is nothing but COD. So, angles subtended by opposite sides are supplementary. In the same way, we can prove the other part also. We can prove other part, that is AOD or DOA plus BOC is also equal to 180, we can prove. Okay, right? I think we completed this exercise. You have understood everything here. One second, children. Let me come back.